The main objection against Ricardian theory of rent was that it is applicable only on one factor of production, that is land. In fact, land has been considered as a free gift of nature, and accordingly, whatever agricultural produce is available on that basis, rent was calculated as a surplus over marginal plot of land. On the other hand, modern theories have a different interpretation of remuneration of different factors of production. According to the modern theory, all factors of production, irrespective of land, labor, capital, organization, or enterprise, all these factors will get rent. Rent is a surplus which all these factors can get. Say, rent itself, or labor by way of wages, capital by way of interest, organization by way of salary, and enterprise by way of profits. Every factor, each and every factor, gets a surplus or a rent. The way of explanation is different, where we say that all these factors can have a non-specific use or may have a specific use. Say, capital, rupees 2 lakhs can be invested in fixed deposit, or it can be invested in tax-free bonds issued by the government of India. Now, there are so many alternatives. If capital has many alternatives, it is non-specific factor. Similarly, an engineer may work as an organization, and he may have 2-3 offers. This means that he is a non-specific factor as organization, because number of opportunities are available. Non-specific factor is one where alternative is available. On the other hand, specific factor is one which may be used only once one option is used, then it becomes a specific factor. For example, money has been invested in tax-free bonds issued by government of India, then that capital becomes a specific factor. Similarly, organization, if someone joins one enterprise, then that becomes a specific factor. Till you have options, you have alternatives, that is non-specific. But the moment you put any factor for a specific use, then it becomes a specific factor or it has one option. Similarly, enterprise, an entrepreneur, can go for one industry or think of setting up other industry. Then in that case, that enterprise is a non-specific factor. But if a businessman chooses a particular industry, it becomes a specific factor. Now here, modern theory says that all specific factors are considered as land. Now this land element may be available in all these factors. Now you can see the difference. There may be two, three alternatives. Now out of these two or three alternatives, or four alternatives or five alternatives, one alternative will be chosen. Now this will be the best option. A person will always use a best option, whereas other four options will be next best. Next best alternative is called opportunity cost, or it is known as transfer earning. Now this next best has a lower remuneration, and this is the best option. For example, organization or labor have two, three options. Say one may get offer of 30,000. Another offer is for 25, 22, 21, 20. Now this will be the best option. So best option is 30,000 minus the next best alternative is 25,000. Therefore, this factor gets a surplus of rupees 500. Now 30,000 is a land element, because now this person will not shift to any other alternative. However, if it is compared with the second option, which is the next best alternative, or the opportunity cost, that difference is a surplus, and this surplus is called rent. It should be clear that all factors of production may have rent, because this is simply a difference between present income. What is the present income of one factor minus the opportunity cost, or transfer earning, whatever it is, present income minus opportunity cost will be called rent. This is the modern theory. In case of Ricardian theory, only land was used where difference in produce of different lots of land was calculated. But now here, we are simply comparing present income minus opportunity cost. Now here, opportunity cost is up to the non-specific. This is specific. Now the difference is because of the specificity of that factor of production. This means 30,000 minus 25,000 is the rent. Now this surplus is because of a specific factor. Now here we find that up to 5,000 rupees there is no alternative available. Means specificity is 5,000. Therefore rent is derived because of the specificity of one factor of production. So far as present income is concerned, well, this present income will be calculated logically. Logically, I mean to say, is that the present income of any factor of production can be determined by the forces of demand and supply. In other words, what is the demand for a factor of production? And what is supply of that factor of production? Wherever demand and supply intersect each other, that will be the point of equilibrium. This equilibrium gives remuneration of a factor of production. So demand is equal to supply is equal to price or remuneration. Price of a factor or a remuneration. This is equilibrium where both the forces determine the value of that remuneration. On that basis, we have to calculate demand as well as supply. Demand is just a simple demand curve which has been examined number of times, where demand of any factor will be sloping downwards to the right. Now here we are considering factor market, not the commodity market. In factor market, well, demand will be again on the basis of remuneration. Or in other words, higher the wages or higher the remuneration, lower will be the demand. Who demands factors? Mainly producer. Producer will demand any such factor depending on the remuneration. You just cannot pay more remuneration because cost of production will be high. Therefore, one has to examine the prevalent rate of remuneration. Demand for a factor is basically governed by the price, by the remuneration, by the amount of remuneration. Therefore, higher the remuneration, well, lower will be the demand. The quantity or units will be in less numbers because price is very high. On the other hand, if price falls, then demand will be high, which is clear that demand will shift from point A to point B. Lower the wages, lower the interest rate, lower the salary, or lower the rent if remuneration is low. Well, in that case, demand for that factor will increase. Now, on the other hand, supply is different. When we talk about supply of all other factors other than labor, then it will be a simple supply curve. A simple supply curve which is sloping upwards to the right. Which means that lower the price, lower the supply, higher the price, higher the supply, again higher the price, again higher the supply. This means that supply of a factor is governed by a price. A producer wants to pay less for the factors of production, but supplier is the factor itself, and the factor will say that if producer offers lower wages, lower interest, lower rent, well, supply will be low. Higher the price, higher will be the supply. In other words, supply of factors depends on the price, prevalent price, and on that basis supply will be determined. But if we are talking about supply of labor, then that supply will be entirely different. Not a single supply curve, but a different supply curve. And that supply curve can be explained here, which will be backward sloping. Labor supply curve will always be backward sloping. In other words, a supply curve of labor starts from a minimum wages. That means OW is the minimum wage. Below this, no worker is prepared to work. In fact, workers must have a subsistence wage, that is a minimum wage. These days, state government, central government, they have a minimum wages act, and accordingly in India, minimum wages have been prescribed. And this minimum wage is determined on the basis of calorie intake for people in rural areas, calorie intake for people in urban areas, and on that basis a minimum wage is determined. All employers have to pay a minimum wage, otherwise they are subject to prosecution. This means that supply curve of labor starts from a minimum wage. For example, minimum wage is 200 rupees. Now at this rate, workers will start working, and you find that this minimum wage is even for the zero worker. For a zero number of workers, the minimum wage is 200. After that, if wages increase, then labor will increase the supply. So higher the wages, higher the supply. Supply will increase. 0 to 100. Then we find that if wages still increase, supposing that from 200 it rose to 350 and now to 500, the supply will increase from 100 to say 180. What is the reason? Every person wants to work more and more. And when higher wages are offered to workers, then they sacrifice leisure. This is very important. At a particular age, workers will like to work more and more, because this is the time at young age to work more and more and to get more and more wages. Therefore, they are prepared to sacrifice their leisure. Even at a higher price, they put in more work, means they sacrifice leisure and prefer to work. They have a work preference. Work preference at a higher wage. So they substitute leisure by more work. Substitution. They change. Substitute leisure by work. L means leisure, W means work. So they substitute for more wages, they leave the leisure and go for more work. Now on that basis, they keep on increasing the labor. So if we join these points, you will find that as and when wages increase, the supply will also increase. Supposing that wages are 650 rupees. On y-axis we are indicating wages in rupees. Now here at 650, again the supply of labor will increase and that will be say 200. Workers are generally self-contented, and if they are getting more and more wages, then after one stage they will not sacrifice leisure. If they are getting more money, well, the option will be to go for leisure. Workers beyond a certain point of wages do not want to work more and more, because they think that whatever they have been earning is sufficient. Hence, if beyond 650 rupees or whatever may be the wages, well, beyond that point they increase in wages to say 750 rupees, will attract less number of workers. The reason is that they have already got lot of money with them. Workers are self-contented. Therefore, at a higher wage, now they will not sacrifice leisure. Rather, they will leisure, they would like to go for rest. Say in the Western countries, 5 days week started. Of course, in India also we have followed the same system. But still, in India people are reverting back to 6 days. However, the preference is for leisure. And when more wages are offered beyond a certain wage level, then they reduce working, they reduce supply. In other words, supply at 750 may lead to lowering down of supply to 140. Now at this point of wages, supply will be less and the supply curve will slope backwards. This is a unique supply curve for only one factor of production, that is labor. A labor supply starts from a minimum wage level. It starts from ₹200. Then, as and when wages increase from 350 to 500 to 650 to 750, we find that wages increase and up to 650, supply of labor also increase. Up to this level, they prefer more work than leisure. But beyond that point of 650, the supply curve starts backward sloping. That is a point where we find that when higher wages are offered, supply will decline. They would prefer more leisure than work. So they substitute work by leisure and the supply curve is backward sloping. It should be clear that the supply curve of labor will always be backward sloping. Therefore, we have now derived demand curve as well as the supply curve, and on that basis now we can have equilibrium or determination of remuneration of one factor of production. This is how we get equilibrium, where we have demand for a factor. In this example, we are taking, say, demand curve for labor. So here we are concerned about quantity of labor, and we want to determine wage rate for the entire industry. Now, demand curve is governed by wage rate, or in other words, higher the wages, lower the demand, lower the wages, higher will be the demand. Now, one point should be very clear, that is that below a supply curve, is the opportunity cost. Workers may get alternative wage anywhere. the area below the supply curve, this entire area below the supply curve, below supply curve is the opportunity cost or where workers may get any amount below the supply curve. In other words, workers have a preference. Workers have the option. Workers may get any such amount by way of their remuneration. Therefore, this area is the opportunity cost. Now, we have to determine the present income, because according to the modern theory, what is rent? Rent is equal to present income minus transfer earning or minus opportunity cost. This will give a surplus, and it is said that rent is a surplus, and this surplus is over the transfer earning of a factory. It may be any factor. It is again repeated that all the five factors of production are entitled to get a surplus by way of rent, and that factor gets rent over and above the transfer earning. Therefore, here demand curve has been drawn. Now, supply curve will start from a minimum wage level, and supply curve will be backward sloping as it has been explained. We draw the supply curve, which is a backward sloping supply curve of labor. We are taking example of labor. Therefore, equilibrium point is E, where wages will be determined. Say, for example, wage is 500 rupees, and at a wage level of 500 rupees, say 200 workers are employed. As I told you, the area below the supply curve is called transfer earning or opportunity cost. The rent is equal to present income minus opportunity cost. In this case, present income is, say, supplied. But since we are taking example of labor, therefore this is a backward sloping curve. And we have determined OWPEM wages. This is the present wage level or present prevalent rate of wages in the labor market, and workers will be offered rupees 500, assuming that there is a perfect competition, the wage rate will be similar, uniform rate will be paid to all the workers. On the other hand, what is the opportunity cost? Opportunity cost is below the supply curve, that is OWEM. Just see this area. This is the opportunity cost, OWEM. So this is a transfer earning or opportunity cost. This opportunity cost is available to workers anytime if they quit and go to other factory where they will get this opportunity cost or this wage. But since market forces have determined wage level at 500 rupees, therefore present income will be this. Hence, a difference between the present income and opportunity cost will be the rent, that is WPE, is the area which indicate rent. This is a surplus over the transfer earning of labor. Therefore, this area will be rent. Now, this rent is possible only when the supply curve is less than perfectly elastic. This curve is less than perfectly elastic. What does it mean? That if supply of labor is, say, perfectly inelastic or perfectly elastic, well, the surplus will be calculated on that basis. In other words, for example, supply is perfectly inelastic or curve is like this. This is the supply. Now this SS is perfectly inelastic supply of labor. In other words, irrespective of any wage level, supply of labor is fixed. There may be certain trades where supply is constant, because that is skilled manpower, trained labor, which is not available in higher quantity because of the technicalities, and therefore here supply of labor is fixed. Now in this case, what is the opportunity cost? Because workers also may not get a job immediately. Employers may refuse. Therefore, opportunity cost is zero. Just see, below the supply curve, opportunity cost is below the supply curve, which is zero. Now, if demand curve intersected, well, the present income will be, say, OP, and the whole amount will be the rent, which is not practical and realistic, because workers have at least a meager amount as an opportunity cost or an alternative. On the other hand, supply curve may be perfectly elastic. Now, if this is the supply curve, this supply curve is perfectly elastic. Now, in this case, the opportunity cost is below the supply curve, and if demand cuts it here, when OSEM is present income, present income is OSEM, whereas the opportunity cost is also same, because opportunity cost is below the supply curve. Therefore, both are equal, means rent will be zero. Now, this is also not a realistic situation. Therefore, it has been said that rent will be available to only those factors which have a supply curve which is less than perfectly elastic. Accordingly, we determine rent as per the modern theory.